dramatically changed. Anyone else to see that? You haven't seen. For those of you who haven't seen all of my videos, you may be wondering, where's number two, bruh? And those of you who have seen my videos will know that I made a video saying that I made a mistake. Underestimate my ability to keep up a habit, and I'm going to say that I managed to post every 3 days for 2 weeks. I have no idea really. You can tell I didn't really prepare very well for this video, and so I was proud of myself for that, but habits aren't always easy to keep up, and I went a bit longer without posting, and I tried to post consecutive days to make up for it, and I thought I'd kind of righted my wrongs, and then everything went downhill, and I'm just posting videos like sometimes it just doesn't work. Even if it's a short video, you know, I'm not working on something for hours and then decide it doesn't work. If I've been working on it for a couple of hours, then I make it work. I'm not letting that time go to waste. But if I'm creating a short, for example, I might just try and get a good take of a little bit of me playing guitar and singing. But sometimes my voice just doesn't sound right, or I don't like the way I'm playing, I'm just not really feeling it, and then I don't end up posting in the end. Anyway, I'm rambling. I know I should be rambling in this video, but I want to make my rambles a bit more interesting, and I want to make you fall asleep because it's relaxing, not make you fall asleep because it's just really incredibly boring. So, essentially, all I'm saying is, if it's been a while since I've posted, just know that I have definitely thought about posting something, or I've intended to post something, but for some reason, it just didn't happen. And I definitely want you to know that I wouldn't abandon you like that. If something ever came up, I would let you know so you're not looking forward to a video, if I can say that you look forward to my videos. Okay, let's move that topic out of the way. That was going on for way too long. I was going on for way too long. Let's go on to a topic that I had intended to mention, and that is my first live video on YouTube. Now, you're probably thinking I'm talking about this as if it's going to happen in the future. No, technically not. I've already had my first live video. And you're all now thinking, when did that happen? I was going to keep it a secret because I wasn't expecting anyone to turn up. That would be really audacious of me to expect a load of people to turn up when I had 100 subscribers or whatever. But I just wanted to give it a go because I think it was during that time when I hadn't posted for a while and I felt bad. I wanted to go live just to see if anyone turned up, just to interact with them directly, because I like going live. I do. I've done it on other platforms and I'm not very confident live, but it's just the feeling of being able to do that and not having to worry about cutting parts out and worrying about it being perfect. You just have to accept it if it's live. And especially, I think going live is a skill. You know, you have to have a heck of a lot of confidence to keep it together. So, something I do want to practice. But my first actual live, it was a few weeks ago, maybe a month ago. And as I said before, it was just during a night. I thought, I haven't posted, so I'm gonna go live. So I did. I was just prepared to do random triggers, random tapping, maybe a little bit of like really soft guitar, speaking, rambling, as I do best, and all that kind of stuff. I think I was live for about 15 minutes. I'm going to say 15 minutes. It may have been longer, but I'm going to make it seem less embarrassing than it was. So, doing my triggers. I'm completely new to this YouTube live, so I don't know what to expect. I was just doing my thing, and I noticed in the corner that it actually said that I say give a like, I mean as long as they appreciate it. There we go. That's the true reason. But I wasn't going to be lazy. I wasn't just going to wait for more people to turn up, because that would be a terrible thing to do. So I continue to do my thing. I think I was doing pretty good. I was wearing my earphones and it sounded pretty relaxing to me. And obviously they continued to not really say anything. I didn't see the number change, I didn't see it go up or go down. But I was happy to have one viewer that liked me so much that they weren't leaving. And I realised a little while afterwards, maybe 5 minutes later, maybe 10 minutes later, who cares? But I noticed a way that I could actually view the current viewers. I could see my current viewers. So I clicked on that and it showed me that the one viewer watching my video was me. YouTube includes the actual broadcaster, the actual owner of the channel, in the list of viewers. And I was not aware of that. First of all, it took me 3 attempts to catch my own finger there. First of all, why do we need to be in that list? That means that when you have 1 million viewers, if that ever happens live, I'm sure it does, if anyone going live has 1 million viewers, they actually have 999,999 viewers, because one of them is themselves. That's a bit misleading, isn't it? A little bit. And secondly, in hindsight, I should have perhaps realised that it could have been just me in a room, just doing a little show for myself, because I didn't get a notification saying that anyone had joined. I don't know if you do. I imagine that if you did get a notification every time someone joined, that would be hella annoying. So again, like I said, I wasn't sure what to expect. I wasn't going to watch videos to learn more about what YouTube Live is like, because I thought it would be fairly obvious how wrong I was. So yeah, that's the little story about how my first live on YouTube was just me doing a 15-minute show to myself. It's not embarrassing that no one turned up. I want to repeat that. That's fine. It's just the fact that I put all of my energy into it and I wasn't going to post it afterwards, because it was my first live. I knew it wasn't going to go the best, but it's the fact that I went all in and I was just doing the show for myself rather than an anonymous viewer. Okay, the next topic, and possibly the last topic. Oops. Okay, the next topic I wanted to address is actually a bit more serious, but I wanted to include it in this video just to clear up any confusion. I recently posted a video, essentially. I've used the word essentially so often in this video. It's like I just learned that word today. What other words can I use? Practically? No, essentially. Fundamentally? Nah. Stupid. Basically is too basic. I'm an English teacher and I have run out of words. How ironic. screen and I was searching for an ASM artist's name. Altian ASMR. They're a French ASM artist. French is my second language. I learned French through school, GCSEs, A-levels. If you want to know more about my education, then I can talk about that in another video. That's how I found her. And it was only the other night, it was a couple of nights ago, that I just happened to see a video come up. It was a notification, because I've turned my bell on for loads of ASM artists. Do people use that expression, I've turned my bell on? I don't want that to sound sexual or anything like that. But I had my notification bell on, and something popped up that was a bit random, something I really didn't expect her to post, and it was claiming to be like an SNL live video where they were talking about Dogecoin. Yeah, I don't know too much about Dogecoin, but I really didn't expect her to post that. Seemed very random, but I watched the live, it was a live video, and it said that it had been removed, so I thought, okay, a bit strange, and it was back in the video section of her channel, saying that it was due to be live in like 5 minutes, so anyway, I checked it out when it went live again. You couldn't comment, there were no comments. At the time that I saw it, there were more dislikes than likes. But eventually the likes actually started to grow, and I think they exceeded the dislikes. Very, very random. Yeah, very confused. But I it wasn't anything that I was going to report at the time, because it was confusion. I had no real idea of what was going on. I kind of stuck around on YouTube watching some other videos, and I decided to search Dogecoin. I was like, I don't really think I suspected anything enough to think that there was some kind of hacking going on, but I decided to search it, and lo and behold, I found very similar videos, the same thumbnail, loads of accounts with the name SNL Live, SNL News, SNL Official, that wasn't official, and it made me realise, you know, what is going on here, it's something really suspicious. Turns out there's been some kind of hack. I don't know whether it was a link that caused some information to be leaked, but about an hour after that video went live on Altian's channel, her account was deleted. I remember that Altian had recently achieved 60,000 subscribers before her account was closed. There is the possibility that she'll get her account back. It's not something which can happen straight away, obviously. But I know that she's actively trying to get her account back at this current moment. So we'll see what happens. But just knowing that she's got that many subscribers makes it clear how much work she's put into her account, how many videos she's posted. I can't remember the exact number of videos she posted, but with 60,000 subscribers, we're aware that it's not come after making 5 videos. So that just kind of puts it into perspective, I guess. The other accounts that had been compromised that I found that had also been hacked, some of those had saying it just to really kind of get an idea of the severity of the situation and how much work has been put into these accounts for them just to go disappear. Shows us how fragile life is, and also how fragile our YouTube channels are. I wasn't originally planning to make this like a deep and meaningful point. I'm not very good at being profound, but if that's how you'll interpret this, and if that's the lesson that you'll get from this, feel free. So that's why I posted that video. I just wanted to address it. I didn't want to ignore it. I feel like it would have been, well, I was going to say like bad, but no, it just wouldn't have felt right to see something like that happen and then just go to sleep. Like, it was late. Yeah. Okay, it was, at the time, was it like 10:30? 10 or 10:30? Yeah. I told you before, I have a bad concept of time, so don't take my word for that. But I'm going to say it was about 10:30. And so, yeah, I could have slept, but I decided to send Altian an email. I realised afterwards that I've sent her to an email that essentially has been compromised, because she'd probably use the same email for her YouTube. Whoops, silly me. But I tried that anyway. Tried to send her a message, but I didn't know what to do, so I posted that video. I wanted to create that so that anyone that was also confused, anyone else that had currently witnessed all of that happening, could actually comment somewhere and share their confusion. And that's why I thought of the brief little video. And I realised that maybe like a week ago, or nearly a week ago, again, I have no real idea whether it was a week ago, it might have been a year ago, but I think a week ago it was something like International Password Day, or International Security Day, something like that. A bit of a coincidence, but this made me think, do I need to change all of the current passwords that I have right now? It's a long and lengthy process, but maybe we need to do it on a regular basis. Anyway, this isn't me trying to be like a father to all of you. Like, I don't know, I could probably do a father roleplay in the future, but this isn't me just telling you what to do and to change all your passwords, but I wanted to speak about it because I'm still feeling a bit weird about it. Yeah. And obviously, before I go, I always want to say thank you to everyone who comments, thank you to everyone who likes my videos. Every single like and comment I know about. I don't want to seem obsessed, but it's made me realise how obsessed you can actually get when you create a YouTube channel and when you start making videos. You really are aware of every single comment that comes in, every single like, the view count, and then obviously getting into the analytics when you have enough views to actually be able to get something from those analytics. But I find it all really interesting, and seeing the views gradually go up, seeing the likes go up, and the amount of comments also going in that direction, it really does spur you on to make more videos, to make videos more regularly, to make better quality videos, of course, but mostly in the early stages, I'd say it's about just making videos regularly, showing your viewers that you're serious about it. It's not just like something that you're doing while you have the motivation, but it's something that you're thinking of doing in the long run. And I'm always going to be more than happy to love heart the I might just not reply if I'm a bit confused about the comment, or if I don't agree with it. I don't want to argue with you, so I might show you that I disagree with the comment by just not replying. A bit more of that passive-aggressive kind of behaviour that I've shown in the past. It's all acting, all acting. But if I haven't commented, of course, don't lose hope. There is a chance that I'm going to comment eventually. I think a lot of the time I'll see your lovely comments and I just can't think of something that really shows how appreciative I am, or you might have said something funny and I can't think of something equally as funny to match it, and I don't just want to leave a really basic response, so I just give myself a bit of time to think of a way that I can respond. That's basically it. So, thanks for coming back. I hope you enjoyed the fact that this was whispered rather than soft-spoken. I was torn between which one I should do, but I know that people have expressed that they like my whispered voice. I hope it's loud enough. I've got my microphone right down here. So, I hope you've heard everything I've just said. Imagine if I just said all that and the microphone hadn't captured it. Yeah, it's happened before, I can deal with it. You have to have those bad early experiences just to learn from it and to know that it's not the end of the world. And especially if it's not the end of the day, you have time to do something else. And even if it's not of the same quality, if it's not of the same length, you can just still feel like your day hasn't been wasted. You've made something of it. And you can go to bed feeling happy. I'm going to stop this riveting ramble right here. So, no real triggers during the video. I could have done a bit of this or a bit of that kind of thing. I just felt like speaking, and I can't concentrate on two things at the same time. It's a bit harsh to say that men can't multitask, because we should never generalise, but that does totally apply to me, unfortunately. The only way that I can multitask is singing while playing guitar, and that took me a while. If you're watching this at night, then sleep well. I hope you have an awesome dream. Multiple dreams. Go crazy. Have all the dreams you want. You deserve every single one of them if you are here right now, especially if you have watched all of this video. If you're watching this video during the day, then awesome. Thank you. I'm glad that you've actually put time aside in your day to watch me. Or if you're just feeling a little bit bored, then I'm glad that you came to me to try and cure your boredom. I shall see you in the next video, whatever that may be. I have no idea. Microphone in one of my drawers in my chest.